By the end of this video, you'll know how to make this effect. So let's get right into it. So for starters, we're gonna grab a fusion composition, and we can do that by coming to Effects, Effects again, and then dragging and dropping this fusion comp into the timeline. We can leave it at the default duration, but for this video, I'm gonna set it to 7 seconds, and later you'll know why. So let's head over to Fusion. And today I'm gonna be covering a more advanced part of Fusion, which is particles. So I'll assume you already have a basic knowledge in Fusion. Let's go. Let's arrange our tools to grid. And the first thing we're gonna do is grab a p-emitter, or particle emitter. And we're gonna also grab a p-render, so we can render our particles. Let's connect it to our media out, and drag it to viewer 2. And we can already see some particles here, which are these little dots right here. But we're gonna make some adjustments to it. We'll come to the p-emitter, and we'll change the number of particles to 70,000. Here in p-render, we gotta make sure that we are at 2D. Now back to the p-emitter. Here in region, we're gonna change it from sphere to bitmap. And what happens now is that if we drag our logo into the node tree, we'll see it appear right here. And what we'll do now so we can actually see the logo, we'll come to p-emitter, controls, and here in color, instead of use style color, we're gonna change it to use color from region. And boom, we can see our logo here. Now what we're gonna do is disconnect our logo for now, let's drag it to our left viewer, and we can see it's at a different format than our main composition. Our main comp is at 3840 by 2160, and our logo is at a square resolution. So what we're gonna do is click the logo, hit shift spacebar, and look for resize. We're gonna add it, and now we're gonna reset our logo size to the size of our main comp. Let's drag our resize to the left viewer, and we can see it looks all weird. So what we're gonna do next is add a transform node and redimension our logo. So let's drag the transform to the left viewer. Let's change the size a little bit. And here we're gonna change the aspect of our logo. Nice, it looks a lot better now. Let's make it a little bit smaller, and now we can start to play. So what we're gonna do next is start to mask out our logo. We're gonna create the mask that will make our particles dissolve. So we'll drag this polygon mask over here, and we're gonna start to mask out our logo. You don't have to be very precise, you can be a bit sloppy at this part. The only thing you'll have to keep in mind is to make it large enough so it can cover the whole logo afterwards. Now we're gonna copy this mask, hitting Command C or Control C, and we're gonna hit Command Shift V or Control Shift V. And what we did was to create an instance mask, or another version of the mask that will have the same settings of our original one. So what we're gonna do is select our instance mask, come to border width, right click it, and then hit deinstance. And this is gonna allow us to change our border width without affecting the original mask. And we're also gonna uncheck this solid option right here. Now we're gonna grab a merge node and connect the output of our upper mask into this yellow input of the merge, and the bottom mask into this green arrow right here. We're gonna drag our merge to our right viewer, and we can't see anything. So what we'll have to do is click on our merge, and here at operator, we're gonna change it from over to XOR. So we'll come to our mask and change the border width, like this. So everything that's inside this white part right here will be visible, and what is in the black part will be invisible. So now we're gonna transform these masks into a black and white image. And we're gonna do that by hitting Shift Spacebar and grabbing a bitmap. Now we're gonna connect our merge to our bitmap, and then hit Shift Spacebar again and find matte control. So let's connect the output of our bitmap into this little gray arrow right here at the bottom, in garbage matte. Now we're gonna grab this transform over here and connect it to the yellow input of the matte control. Now all we have to do is connect our matte control to the p-emitter. Let's drag our media out to the viewer, and there's our logo. Now what we'll have to do is come to matte control, then garbage matte, and click on invert. And the hardest part of our composition is done. So now what we're gonna do is add forces to our particles so they can start to move around. But before that, make sure to subscribe to the channel so you don't miss on any other videos that I post here on the channel every week. So let's organize our node tree, and now making sure p-emitter is selected, we're gonna hit shift spacebar and type p-d-i. And we're gonna add this p-directional force. And this is gonna give some direction to our particles. So here in direction, we're gonna change it from minus 90 to 45. This is gonna give us sort of an upper right direction to the particles. And we can already see the effect starting to happen. Now we're gonna add a p-turbulence. And we're gonna change these properties to 0.2, 0.2, 0.3. And here in density, we're gonna type 50. And this is gonna make our particles dissolve in a more of a random way. So now we're gonna animate our first mask. So let's go back to our polygon mask. We're gonna come to frame 0, set a keyframe here at center, drag the mask out of the image. Now we're gonna come to frame 119, and we're gonna pull it back until it covers our whole logo. Cool, now we're getting to the final part of our composition, and we're gonna grab our media 1, our resize, and our transform, copy them and paste them right here. Now we're gonna connect them with a merge. And make sure our transform is connected to the green input of the merge node, which is our foreground. And now we can see our logo back again. So now we're gonna copy this first mask right here, paste it here, and mask out our merge node. Now we're gonna check invert and solid. We can also soften the edge a little bit, and our effect is ready. So what we did was to leave the comp 2 seconds longer, so we can see all of our particles disappear before the video ends. Now let's see how it looks. And if you want to learn another cool effect inside DaVinci Resolve, make sure to check out this video showing on your screen right now, and I'll see you there.